Let's face it, size, it matters. You know it, I know it, our parents know it. Let's be real for a second here. When it comes down to it, it can literally make all the difference. We're talking about displacement here. I'm Dustin with Custom Offsets, and today we're gonna be taking a quick little look-see at all the engine options available today. From EcoBoost diesels to Godzillas, Micro Duramaxes to Voodoo engines, and even the highly debated EcoBoosts, we really had to know what's the hype with all these engine displacements. Jumping right into it, if you need wheels, tires, or suspension for your truck, you can find that right over at customoffsets.com. Also, if you want to take a look at like 70,000 beautiful trucks and see what fits trucks just like yours, you can do that at customoffsets.com/gallery. All right, back to our scheduled programming. While there's no replacement for displacement, or so they say anyways, you can't help but notice the resurgence in the last few years of the mega-sized gas engines. To understand exactly why this is happening, we had to first hit the old rewind button to figure out why they went away in the first place. Let's take it way back. GM had introduced the ever popular small block V8 in 1955 and had seen really great success from it. This roaring V8 engine could be found in nearly every one of their production cars in its early years and paved the way for the modern internal combustion engine as we know it today. This was all fine and dandy, but GM needed something larger to power their medium-duty trucks and the heavier cars that were on the horizon. Thus, the big block engine was born. The first GM big block was introduced in 1958 and was 348 cubic inches. Best part, this 5.7 liter V8 made a whopping 250 engine horsepower. Over the next few decades, all the major manufacturers would begin offering big engines in their cars and trucks for a whole host of reasons. As vehicles began to become more defined, the demand shifted to higher horsepower and more. Higher horsepower and more power? Is that what you said? The demand shifted to higher horsepower and more torque. Cue the donut media, more power, baby! The 70s brought a lot of changes to the global economy, but most notably is the oil crisis of both 1973 and 1979. As the Yom Kippur War and the Iranian Revolution took place, Middle Eastern oil exports were interrupted quite significantly. This led to nearly stagnant economic growth in countries as oil prices surged. No longer did people want massive, fire-breathing, bald eagle-screaming American V8 engines, and instead, people began searching out and purchasing smaller imported vehicles with far more fuel-efficient engines. As the 80s, 90s, and even 2000s came and went, the industry transitioned away from carbureted, fuel-guzzling V8s and started to transition into fuel-injected, cleaner-burning, and more efficient engines. Additionally, the EPA began to impose further restrictions on both the gas and diesel markets, demanding that manufacturers begin to make their engines more fuel efficient and cutting emissions significantly. This led manufacturers to downscale their engines and often entertain forced induction to help attain these strict mileage and emission requirements. This would ultimately usher in the era of eco engines, the most notably of these, the Ford EcoBoost. This would go on for several years with engines getting smaller, trucks getting bigger, and just overall fuel efficiency slimming down and trimming the fat. All of this changed in 2019, however. Ford created huge waves by releasing what they called, fittingly enough, the Godzilla engine. If you're not familiar, Godzilla is a 7.3 liter pushrod, fire-breathing American V8 engine. It features an iron block, aluminum heads, a forged steel crankshaft, and 430 horsepower. This ushered in a new era of horsepower, and within a year, both GM and Ram had also jumped on board with new large displacement gasoline engines in their full-size pickups. Back again were the days of the high displacement, high horsepower V8s that we had all come to love over the years. At the same time that gas engines are getting bigger, the compression-fired diesel engines are actually trending smaller. You can now get a small 3.0 liter diesel engine in pretty much every half ton on the market, Ford, Dodge, and GM. This allows torque that your everyday driver may need while still getting high fuel efficiencies to remain economical. No longer did you have to have a 3/4 or 1 ton truck to enjoy the dependability and reliability of diesel engines. You can now get them in the half ton truck that you love. But with all that being said, the people still want to know, what is the hype with all these engine offerings? And honestly, it's pretty simple if you ask me. On the one end, you have the full-size truck market, which is swinging into large displacement gasoline engines because they offer those truck owners the simplicity and reliability of a gasoline engine while still giving them the towing and hauling capability that they need. On the other side of the spectrum, you have the small eco-diesel guys that are getting reliability and fuel efficiency from a diesel engine while still in a half-ton truck, which is perfect for hauling the boat to the lake on the weekends and picking up the kids from soccer practice on a Wednesday night. What do you guys think of all these new engines? Love them or hate them? Let us know down in the comments section below, and make sure that you like, share, and subscribe so we can keep bringing you guys banging content just like this. Peace.